Dear students, welcome to the class 2 of your module 2 of Engineering Statistics and Linear Algebra. In class 1, in our previous session, you studied about the properties of PDF and CDF of two random variables. And we also worked out one problem of finding the CDF. Okay. Now in this session, we will work out few more problems. Once again, recall the properties of PDF and CDF which you studied in the previous session. All the properties are required to work out the problems. Now, I am giving you those properties once again, which is the first property. If your two-dimensional CDF is given to you, how to find a single, that means independent CDF. For example, fxy of infinity comma y, that means in the place of x, if you take infinity, it becomes the CDF of single random variable. Similarly, fxy of x comma infinity, in the place of y, if you take infinity, it gives you CDF of the single random variable x. Okay, and from the CDF, how to find PDF? This is the relation. We differentiate CDF once with respect to x and once with respect to y to get the PDF. And if PDF is given, how to find CDF? This is the formula. We integrate the PDF between minus infinity to x and minus infinity to y with respect to x and y. So remember that minus infinity to x are limits for x and minus infinity to y are limits for y. And in your CDF, if you put both variables as infinity, fxy of infinity comma infinity, it is nothing but, if you use this formula, it is nothing but your upper limits are infinity here. So it is double integral minus infinity to infinity, minus infinity to infinity, integral of PDF with respect to x and y. Actually, it gives you the total volume under the surface of your PDF and answer is equal to 1. And if bivariate PDF is given to you, fxy of x comma y is given to you, how to find individual PDF? So to find individual PDF fx of x, we integrate the bivariate PDF with respect to the other variable. Other variable is y here. To get fx of x, other variable is y. We integrate with respect to y. Similarly, to find individual PDF fy of y from the bivariate PDF, we integrate bivariate PDF with respect to the other variable x. So remember all these properties. And if probability of this type of values are given with the limits, probability of x and y, where x varies from x1 to x2 and y varies from y1 to y2, if limits are given to you, then your value is given by the integral of PDF fxy of x comma y between these limits. X1 to x2 are limits for x, inner integration, and y1 to y2 are limits for y. And actual meaning of your fxy of x comma y is equal to, the CDF is equal to probability that x is less than or equal to x, as well as capital Y is less than or equal to y. So this is the meaning of your CDF. Now if CDF of two variables x and y, that means bivariate CDF, is equal to product of two individual CDFs, in that case we say that x and y are independent. Same case holds good if you are having the product of two individual PDFs is equal to bivariate PDF, then also x and y are independent. So depending on the question, you may have to use these properties. Okay. So let us work out one problem now. Remember all these properties once again. So one example, the joint PDF fxy of x comma y equal to c, where c is a constant when 0 is less than x less than 3 and 0 less than y less than 3 and 0 otherwise. Okay, so joint PDF is given to you. function value is c when x is in between 0 and 3 and y is in between 0 and 3. So function can be defined in two steps like this. Value is c in this interval and 0 otherwise. 0 otherwise means other than these two regions, in all other regions value is 0. Question is, what is the value of the constant c? What are the PDFs of x and y? PDFs of x and y means individual PDFs are asked. What is capital Fxy of x, y? That means what is the CDF? And what are Fxy of x, infinity and capital Fxy of infinity, y? Are x and y independent? So these are the 5 questions asked with the given PDF. PDF is a very simple function. It is a constant C. So first question, how to find the value of the constant C? For this, remember one property. What is the property? Integral 0 to infinity, integral 0 to infinity, fxy of x, y dx dy equal to 1. Actually, property is starting from lower limit as minus infinity. Minus infinity to infinity, minus infinity to infinity. But in our definition here, x is greater than 0, y is also greater than 0 as per the given interval. So we are starting from 0 here. Again, no need to take upper limit as infinity because in our first definition, upper limit is 3 for x and upper limit is 3 for y. Okay, so after 3, more than 3, you need not have to consider. So consider here 0 to 3 for x value and 0 to 3 for y value limits. And integrate, your function given is c, dx dy equal to 1. Now you can evaluate this integral, very simple integral, which contains both pair of limits as constants, inner limits as well as outer limits. Okay, integration of c with respect to x is c into x. Apply the limits from 0 to 3, you get 3 into c. Again, integrate that with respect to y, you get 3 into c into y. Apply the limits from 0 to 3 and answer is equal to 1 from our property. Substitute, you get c equal to 1/9. So this gives you the answer for your first question. What is the value of c? Now, what is the second question? What are PDFs of x and y? PDFs for x and y means individual PDFs are required. How to find individual PDF? PDF of x is given by integrating the joint PDF with respect to the other variable. Remember, so use that property now. So fx of x is minus infinity to infinity fxy of x comma y dy. And for dy, for the variable y, which are the limits as per the first definition, limits are from 0 to 3. In other region, function value becomes 0. So take only this region, y value from 0 to 3, c into dy. So you get cy from 0 to 3. Apply the limits. When you substitute for c, you get answer 1/3. So fx of x is also a constant from 0 to 3. In this problem, you are getting constant. Sometimes you may get also a function of x. So we are using this notation, fx of x, function of x. In this problem, since your PDF is a constant, CDF is also a constant. You are getting here 1/3 and this is valid in this interval. That means in other regions, function value is 0. How to find PDF of y? PDF of y is fy of y equal to minus infinity to infinity fxy of x, y dx. That means integration of PDF with respect to the other variable. Other variable is x here. Substitute and integrate, you get answer 1/3. And this is valid in this interval 0 to 3. So if PDF is known, joint PDF is known, you can find the individual PDFs. Third question, C question. Find fxy of xy, that means CDF, find CDF when 0 is less than x less than 3 and 0 is less than y less than 3. So no need to consider different cases here, only this case is required. So first write the definition of x, fxy of x comma y. Here in the question, PDF is given. So using PDF, how to find the CDF? We need this relationship. Substitute. Here, minus infinity to x are the limits for x. But as per the condition given here, x is from 0 to 3. X is in between 0 and 3. That means x is clearly greater than 0. So you can start from 0 to x. And limits for y are 0 to 3. And y is in between 0 and 3. So integration from minus infinity to y can be written as 0 to y. C dx dy. Okay, why we have taken this interval? Because of this region. Region is given. Integrate C into integration with respect to x. You get x. Up limits are 0 to x. So upper limit for x is x itself, no change. Answer becomes C into x. And lower limit is 0. Cx into, now again integrate between the limits 0 to y. Cx into y, you get. Cx into y means C is 1 by 9, already obtained in your first sub-question. Substitute. So answer for CDF in this region is 1 by 9 xy. So this is the answer for your third question. What is the fourth question? They asked you to find fxy of x comma infinity. And fxy of infinity comma y. Remember the property. Fxy of x comma infinity is nothing but individual CDF fx of x. Okay. F capital fxy of x comma infinity is nothing but individual CDF of capital x, fx of x. So write the property. Capital fx of x is given by capital fxy of x comma infinity. Substitute. Here actually this infinity means maximum value of y is taken. But in our definition, maximum value of y is 3. So instead of infinity, you can take 3. That means after 3, there is no function value. So fxy of x comma 3. Now, fxy is obtained in your previous sub-question. Substitute. You got fxy of x comma y as 1 by 9 into xy. Substitute 1 by 9 into xy. Y is 3. So answer is x by 3 from 0 to 3. Similarly, you can find individual CDF of y. Fy of y equal to, okay, actually inside the bracket, it should be small y, small letter y. Fy of small y equal to fxy of infinity comma y. We put x equal to infinity. You get fxy of highest value of x is 3 as per the definition. So substitute, you get y by 3 finally. And which are the limits for y? Y limits are 0 to 3. That means this CDF definition is valid in this interval. So this is regarding your fourth sub question. Now fifth question, whether x and y are independent. You have a question whether x and y are independent. What are the conditions for independent events, independent random variables? Either you should have this property, capital fxy of x comma y is equal to capital fx of x into capital fy of y. That means bivariate CDF is equal to product of individual CDFs. Or another equivalent property is that bivariate PDF is equal to product of individual PDF. Now already we obtained individual PDFs in our second question from question number B. Once again go back to your question number B and check the answer. You obtained fx of x equal to 1 by 3 in this interval. Individual PDF of x is 1 by 3. Similarly, we obtained individual PDF of y equal to 1 by 3. Multiply these two individual PDFs. When you multiply, you get fx of x into fy of y. Answer is 1 by 3 into 1 by 3. And region we consider both. Common to both conditions. 0 less than x less than 3 and 0 less than y less than 3. What is this answer? 1 by 3 into 1 by 3 means 1 by 9. 1 by 9 is nothing but C value. So it is nothing but your given definition. What is the given definition? fx y of x comma y is given as c, that means 1 by 9 in this interval. Clearly, x and y are independent. Product of individual CDFs is equal to product of individual PDFs equal to bivariate PDF. Hence, x and y are independent. So, this is about your first type of question where bivariate PDF is given to you and they asked some CDF and PDFs for individual random variables. Now, a different type of question. A bivariate random variable has the CDF fxy of x comma y equal to c into x plus 1 whole square into y plus 1 whole square, and the limits for x are minus 1 to 4 and limits for y are minus 1 to 2. See the difference. In the previous example, bivariate PDF was given to you. In this example, bivariate CDF is given to you. What is the question here? What is the value of C? What value must C have? First question. Second question, find the bivariate PDF. Third question, find the CDFs, individual CDFs, fx of x and fy of y. Evaluate P of x less than or equal to 2 intersection y less than or equal to 1. And fifth question, are the bivariate random variables independent? So again, you have five simple questions. Start from the given CDF. First, start from the given CDF. So what is CDF given? Fxy of x comma y equal to c into x plus 1 whole square into y plus 1 whole square, where x is in between minus 1 and 4 and y is in between minus 1 and 2. To find c, when PDF is given, how do you find c? We integrate from minus infinity to infinity and answer is 1. Same integral in terms of CDF, I have given this notation in the beginning of this session. The same double integral minus infinity to infinity becomes capital Fxy of infinity comma infinity. So since here CDF is given, we need to use this property. So Fxy of infinity comma infinity answer is 1. And what is maximum value of x? 4. So no need to take infinity, just to take 4. And what is the maximum value of y? 2. Write it, 2. That means after 4 and after 2 here, after x equal to 4 and after y equal to 2, the function definition comes in your second definition. So answer is 0. So only take maximum value here 4, maximum value here 2. Substitute. Okay. Fxy of 4 comma 2. Substitute c into 4 plus 1 whole square into 2 plus 1 whole square equal to 1, which is c into 225. Calculate this, you get 225, which is equal to 1. So answer c equal to 1 by 225. This gives you the answer for your first question. Actually, here it is A, first question A. And what is our second question now? Go to the second question. They asked you to find bivariate PDF. How to find bivariate PDF if bivariate CDF is given? So you need this property now. So remember all the properties. You differentiate bivariate CDF twice. That means once with respect to y and once with respect to x to get the bivariate PDF. Substitute. What is your bivariate CDF given? Substitute. It is understood this is the definition taken from your first step, and in second step function value is 0. Clearly differentiation will be 0. So I have taken only first step definition here. Differentiate. You cannot directly write the second order partial derivative. So what you can do? First differentiate with respect to the inner variable. Inner variable is y. So I am splitting this as dou by dou x into dou by dou y of c into x plus 1 whole square into y plus 1 whole square. Differentiate this only with respect to y first. When you differentiate with respect to y, the c into x plus 1 whole square is a constant. So write this c into x plus 1 whole square as it is. And what is the derivative of y plus 1 whole square? When you differentiate with respect to y, you get 2 into y plus 1. Now, this answer you need to differentiate with respect to x now. Differentiate. When you differentiate with respect to x, c is a constant, 2 is a constant, y plus 1 is a constant. First write these three constants. Remaining is x plus 1 whole square. Derivative is 2 into x plus 1. So, combine these, you get the answer 4c into x plus 1 into y plus 1. That means 4 by 225. C value is 1 by 225 we obtained in the previous sub-question. Substitute 4 by 225 into x plus 1 into y plus 1. And what is the definition valid in this interval? In the first definition, minus 1 to 4 and minus 1 to 2. So, if bivariate CDF is given to you, you can find bivariate PDF. Go to the third sub-question now. C. Individual CDFs are asked. Capital Fx of x and capital Fy of y are asked. And here in the question, they have given fx, capital fx, y of x comma y, bivariate CDF is given. So, how to use that bivariate CDF? As we have worked out the previous problem, individual CDF is given by putting y equal to infinity in your fx, y of x comma y to get individual CDF of x. So, put y equal to infinity, but maximum value of y is 2 as per the definition. So, substitute here. You get fx y of x comma 2, you get c into x plus 1 whole square into 2 plus 1 whole square. Answer is 9 by 225 into x plus 1 whole square. And the interval is minus 1 to 4. Valid definition. This is valid in this interval. Same method we use for the individual CDF of y. Capital Fy of y equal to capital Fx of fxy of infinity comma y. We put x equal to infinity and there is no condition for y, that's why we are getting function of y. Substitute, what is the maximum value of x as per the definition? 4. So instead of infinity we take 4. Substitute, you get c into 4 plus 1 whole square into y plus 1 whole square, which is 25 by 225 into y plus 1 whole square. And it is valid in this subinterval, minus 1 to 2. This is your third sub-question, which is required to find these individual CDFs. The fourth sub-question is probability of x less than or equal to 2 intersection y less than or equal to 1. Remember the definition of your CDF. What is the definition of CDF? Fxy of x comma y is nothing but probability of x less than or equal to x and y less than or equal to y. So when you use the CDF here, already CDF is given to you in the question. So directly your upper limit of x is 2 and upper limit for y is 1 CDF. Substitute, you get c into 2 plus 1 whole square into 1 plus 1 whole square. You get 36c. Calculate and check it. That means answer is 4 by 25 after substituting the value of C. And what is your fifth question now? Capital Fx of x into Fy of y. Fifth question was to check whether they are independent. X and y are independent. So find, here we don't have the PDFs to multiply and check. We don't have the individual PDFs. We have the individual CDFs as per the previous questions. So, multiply individual CDFs. When you multiply fx of x with fy of y, you get this product. Simplify this. When you simplify this, you get 1 by 225 into x plus 1 whole square into y plus 1 whole square. And interval is understood, the first definition, minus 1 to 4 and minus 1 to 2. When you multiply these two, you get, this is nothing but the given definition, the bivariate CDF fxy of x comma y. So we proved that product of two individual CDFs is equal to bivariate CDF. Hence x and y are independent. So we worked out two problems now. In first problem, PDF was given to you and different type of questions are asked. And in the second question, CDF was given to you and you worked out some sub questions. Now, similar one problem I am giving to you for your practice. Practice problem 1. This is similar to our first worked out problem. The joint PDF fxy of x, y equal to c, where c is a constant and interval is 0 to 2 for x and 0 to 3 for y and 0 otherwise. What is the value of constant c? So first you have to find the value of constant c. What are PDFs for x and y? PDFs for x and y means individual PDFs. What is fxy of x, y when x is in between 2 and y is in between 3? CDF. So CDF is asked, but no need to take different cases. Only this case is enough. When x is in between 0 and 2, y is in between 0 and 3. What are capital fxy of x, infinity and capital fxy of infinity, y? Are x and y independent? It is similar to previous worked out problem, only I think interval is different here, just for your practice. So practice, answers are given, just verify whether you get the answer. Okay, in case if you don't get the answer, you just send me your solutions, I will verify. So this is first type of problem for your practice. Second type of problem for your practice is, a bivariate random variable has the following CDF. CDF is given to you. Okay, here actually function is also same, similar to your worked out problem, only I changed the interval here. Okay, it will be a good practice problem for you. Outside the given intervals, the bivariate CDF is as required by theory. That means it is understood, we take it as 0. What value must C have? Find the bivariate PDF. Find the CDFs fx of x and fy of y. Evaluate p of x less than or equal to 2 intersection y less than or equal to 1. Whether bivariate random variables are independent. So these are the questions. Here I have given you the answer only for A and C. I think it is A and D, not A and C. Because in C you are getting CDFs. They cannot be constants. A and D. So this is the answer for D. Correct this. So I have given you the answer for A and D. Just verify. Send your answers to me. I will verify and tell you. Okay. So we discussed various properties of PDF and CDF. We worked out different types of problems. In the next session, we will study about expectation. That means mean. How to find the mean of two random variables. Okay, it is just an extension of your formula you studied under one variable. So we will continue that in the next session. Thank you.